Hello, good morning. Welcome to another time of KC Video Devotionals for Singles. Today is the 1st of March. My name is Oni Elizabeth. Our topic for today is how to know who to fall in love with or not. God is a God of order. So when He created you and I, He gave us brains that we should be able to think. He then gave us His word to guide us. His principles are well spelled out in His word. So when it comes to getting direction from God concerning relationships and marriage, there are some things we don't need to ask God again because He already told us in His word. You cannot get married to anybody and everybody. There are some people to avoid. You see, when you fall in love with the wrong person, there is no point asking God about it because His word already told you not to fall in love with such people. That is why we never get answers to some of our prayers, because His word clearly gave the answer already. This is what the Bible is talking about when it says we ask amiss. James 4 verse 3, KJV translation. Ye ask and receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lust. Amplified version says it better. James 4 verse 3, Amplified translation. Or you do ask God for them and yet fail to receive, because you ask with wrong purpose and evil, selfish motives. Your intention is when you get what you desire, you spend it in sensual pleasures. Who is this person you should never fall in love with? Don't fall in love with a God hater. You cannot fall in love with God haters. Oh, that the eye of your understanding be open to know the consequences of doing such. This is the first and foremost quality to consider before making a decision. If he is not born again, if he does not fear God, don't bother to go and ask God if it is okay. His word already clearly says not to do so. 2 Corinthians 6 verse 14, Message translation. Don't become partners with those who reject God. How can you make a partnership out of right and wrong? That's not partnership, that's war. Is light best friends with darkness? Light cannot get into marital union with darkness. An unbeliever is a fool according to God's word. When you say you don't want God in your life, what you're saying, in other words, is that there is no God. Psalm 14 verse 1, KJV translation. The fool had said in his heart, there is no God. The issue is that a God hater can seem nice. A God hater can have some money, like Nabal, who was foolish and yet had money. The example shows that a beautiful, intelligent woman can end up with a foolish man, all the name of love. 1 Samuel 25 verse 3, Message translation. The man's name was Nabal, fool, a Kelabite, and his wife's name was Abigail. The woman was intelligent and good-looking. The man brutish and mean. But you see, the man ended his life and would have wiped out his whole family alongside. It was just as the scripture says. Proverbs 1 verse 32, KJV translation. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. So you see that a God hater or a fool can have money, but that very prosperity will destroy them. So before you fall in love, before you are lost in rapturous embrace of a man or woman that has no regard for God, think very well. Before you allow your mountain feeling take ascendance over your spirit, watch it before your reasoning is ignored and your sensitivity is dulled because of love. Watch it. You see, the scripture clearly warns about that. A man or a woman who does not know God is incapable of loving you properly. God is love, and you have to know God before you can properly love another. Most of what is professed as love is just simply lust. God will not change his mind about that. It is foolhardy to go and be asking God that you will change the person. You are not the Holy Spirit, and you will not be able to change anybody. You're not even halfway into changing yourself. Also, beware of people that tell you they will change after marriage. It is a trap. Don't walk into a marriage like you've been drugged. Don't pack out of your parents' house into a man's house whom you already know has a wife somewhere and is promising you heaven and earth about taking care of you. Don't be caught up in the greatest pain of our generation, the deceitfulness of riches. What if you've already fallen in love with someone who does not know God and has made it clear he is not interested in God? Just simply rise out of the love you've fallen into. No more. You fell in love, right? Just get up and get out of the love and preserve your life and destiny. Your assignment and purpose in life should not be buried and ended in the kitchen of a God hater. Deliver yourself and fly away. Proverbs 6 verse 5, deliver thyself as a roe from the hand of the hunter and as a bird from the hand of the fowler. Think deeply, pray well, read and study God's word endlessly, and you will know what is wrong and what is right. And when you know, do not deliberately disobey God because you are in love. You don't fall in love hopelessly and helplessly. You fall in love deliberately and consciously because at the end of the day, you will live with your choice. What if you find it difficult to leave him or her despite knowing it will never work out? It's because you have been sexually involved. A soul tie has been effected and an illegal bonding as a result of premarital sex has been initiated. You must muster courage and every ounce of strength in you and deliver yourself so that you will not regret later. The moment you have compromised, the soul enters into confusion and you can't think straight again. What to do? Run to God and ask for his mercy. Watch whom you fall in love with so you don't fall into a ditch. God will help us all in specific ways we need him in Jesus' name. He will come into your situation and give you light. Meditation for the day. Proverbs 6 verse 5. Run like a deer from the hunter. Fly like a bird from the trapper. Prayer for the day. O Lord, help me to make the right decisions. Prayer 2. My God, break every ungodly soul tie keeping me bound. Prayer 3. My Father, deliver me from wrong relationships. Confession for the day. I will not miss it in life. I will follow God. I will not fall in love with a wrong person. In the name of Jesus, every soul tie is severed and broken. The Lord delivers me from all wrong bonds. I am delivered from all forms of manipulation and oppression. Action plan for the day. Make a list of people who should not be part of your life and start disconnecting.
We'd like you to partner with us in Cases in Us Club. To do so, kindly use the banking information you see on the screen. And for international giving, please navigate to the URL you see on the screen at casesandus.com/give. God bless you as you do so. This devotional is taken from our books for single married, and these books are available on Amazon and on Kada Books. In order to access the books, kindly navigate to the URL you see on the screen at casesandus.com/books. If you live in the city of Ibadan, we'd like you to watch with us at Shouts of Grace Center. It's at Joker Plaza beside Trans Amusement Park, Odija UI Road, in the city of Ibadan. On Sundays, we have two services by 7:30 and 9 o'clock, and by Wednesdays, 6 p.m. It will be our pleasure to have you. Kindly follow us on Cases and Us Club at casesandus.com. You'll have a lot of resources for your soul.